chest. All that talk about the best. You know how sticky it gets.
Like, we weren't supposed to come up with something this clean. Like, something happened.
What's up, guys? How's it going? Welcome to the stream. Welcome, welcome. Good morning. Good afternoon. Hollywood. Yeah, we got a 9 a.m. special. It's going pretty well over here. Thank you for hopping in. I feel like I worked with you on Durex. I'm not sure, though. I believe I remember. What's up, guys? What's up, Sebastian? How you guys doing? I'm gonna wait for some people to file in. It's only been a minute.
I've been alone in my thoughts.
That's loud. Has anyone in this chat used Premiere Rush before? Because that's what we're learning today. See if we got any experience. Alex, it's going well. I'm over here in New York. So, you know, it's midday. We've been awake. Got our coffee going. Thank you for asking. Doing a little streaming today so that we can share this as best we can. Doing well, Sebastian. Doing well. Excited to share. That's hilarious. Katie's up in this. Katie Holler, shout out. Yeah, doing pretty well. Excited to share a little bit about... You already know it, Christopher. You already know it. Yeah, I hadn't been using Premiere Rush until more recently. So I found it to be super helpful. What's up, Cesar? Oh, how we doing? How we doing, Cesar? Good to see you around. Hope you're enjoying your residency here. Over in VMLA, I take it. Awesome. Well, we could jump in, I'd say. I mean, we still got a few minutes to let people file in here. This is obviously a session on Premiere Rush. Now, it appears people haven't really touched Premiere Rush quite yet, which is completely fine. I hadn't started using Premiere Rush for a little bit. What's up, Simon? How you guys doing? How we doing? Love it. Good to see you here. Good to see you. So Premiere Rush is, you know, a great tool. The thing about us is we're all creators here, and we're all people that are making, and it's going to be, you know, mainly TikTok, but also across platforms a lot of times. So let me turn off Drake. Drake's a little distracting here. Is he not? He's a little distracting. So Premiere Rush, right? This is it in the App Store. So this is kind of your opportunity to download it for yourself. A lot of people will have, actually anyone who's in the creative department will have access to an Adobe login. So you guys can all feel free to download it and you know, input your Adobe login and you'll be logged in the same way you would be for Photoshop and Premiere and all those good After Effects, so on and so forth. So the great thing is we could all use this. There are other options, of course. I've heard a lot of people that like using CapCut, InShot, Splice. If you guys wouldn't mind dropping in your preferred method of editing, that would be cool to kind of get a sense. You know, it could be TikTok. It could be, you know, hey, I edit in app. Hey, it could be Premiere on the desktop. It could be InShot. It could be so many options. Splice, I know a lot of people like Splice, but it does cost money. So this is the free version of Splice, and it's going to give you a lot of the same features as Splice. So that's why we're here. I pretty much swear by it because I can literally be at the gym, on the treadmill, recording a video, or editing a video, rather. You're not going to be able to record, but that is Premiere on desktop. Yeah, that was me for quite a while. Premiere Pro, CapCut. Yeah, Premiere Pro. Yeah, drop your brand in there too so we can kind of get a sense of where everyone's at. Noelle, Premiere on desktop, Premiere Pro. Oh, this is great. People use Premiere Pro, which is very good for our purposes because, this is going to be an easier transition over to Premiere Rush. And, you know, once you shoot your footage, you don't have to wait to get home to edit it. It's like, boom, boom. It's just, you can literally input it into your, I think we're pretty much ready. How many people we got up in here? 29 people. That's pretty solid. Casper, Dream Team. What up, Simon? Oh, absolutely. We're working with Simon as we speak. Chosen Foods here. Love it. Premiere, Unstoppable Domains. Welcome, welcome. Devon. How you guys doing? Awesome. So, the market, shows its admiration for TikTok, Premiere, Instagram Reels, YouTube Shorts. Everyone is a video creator at this point, so everyone's gonna get a chance to use Premiere Rush. Indeed, nice. We got a lot of VMLA folks out here. Shout out VMLA. I gotta come see that office sometime. It was fun working with the Durex crew, and we're, of course, working with Land's End right now, Katie and I. So here we go. Let's dive in. Premiere Rush. You've all had a chance to download it in the App Store at this point, I assume. So here we go. We're jumping in. There's the camera roll. So it literally goes right up. But what you'll see when you first open it is this, like, your projects window. This is like, you know, this is your desktop, so to speak. This is your project library. And you can, start new projects, and you can see when I hit the gear, you can see I'm signed in. Everyone's got their subscription, so that's cool. You got preferences, not much to see there. About Rush, yep. Cool, not much in the settings. So at the bottom, you'll see a plus sign. That's where you will, it says add media, take video or photo. So you can actually capture in the app, but I certainly don't recommend that. I recommend using your camera on your iPhone, getting the footage the way you want to, and stockpiling your footage, then heading over to Premiere Rush or Premiere Pro. Depends on the speed in which you need to edit. So I'm gonna open up CapCut here. I've been working on some stuff for Casper, and this is a sneak preview for all the Casper folks out there. Let's see. So we were at the mall yesterday. We had some fun. This is a little skip to my loo video, where, it's describing the feeling. You just got a Casper mattress. They come in a box. So, we're going to call this project Skip to My Lou. And then, V1, because you can really organize this. And by the way, like, as you guys follow along, feel free to start a project of your own. This could literally be a working session. Like, shit, let's walk out of here with some work to show. Why not? So there you go. I typically don't do any spaces because for file management, it works better that way, to not have any spaces in your title. Something about the computer indexing the file. So we create that. Here it goes. Preparing media. Just like that, it's dropped everything in. So now, using my two fingers, you can zoom, kind of the way you'd zoom in on anything. And as you can see here, it's just a lot more fine-tuned than TikTok. TikTok's going to give you like every 0.1 seconds as your cutting points. And that's just not going to cut it for artists like us, people who want great edits. So here I go, clowning around in the mall. We're going to wait till kind of the first. Yeah, so there I go. Skipping down as I got my mattress. So I click on the clip. It's already selected, but I click on the clip, and then I hit split. I've just made a split. The heads here don't matter. So I click it again, hit delete. Now, there I go. That seems like the amount of time before I lose interest, right? It's TikTok, so you lose interest extremely fast. I'm gonna look for the next point in this clip that looks interesting and hit split. Click on this in between and hit delete. So we're ending up here. Let's play that. Kind of hear it. Nice. So I've already left the frame. Boom. The second I'm leaving the frame, we're cutting away. You know, it's the amount of time before people lose interest is unprecedented these days. So here you go. I reappear. We're going to make another split. And, you know, the in-between section, chop it off. Goodbye. Here I go. Skip to my loo. There's Casper. And worth noting, this is like when you're going to go to a mall or whatever. The person capturing this, my girlfriend, she did a great job of not capturing other brands here. So, because you start to run into issues then, you're going to have to go into Premiere. You're going to have to start to blur things out. All right. So, gotta get the close up. So we make a split here and we kill all this. What's up, Alex? All right. So, yeah, we heard a little like laugh there. So you'll get to see kind of how like fine tuned it can get. So now that I have this clip selected, I'm gonna click on the end here, the end, and I can go doot doot doot. It gets really fine tuned, and you can zoom in. You can zoom in even more actually, and it can get really fine tuned. So you can get like every last millisecond chopped to perfection. All right, so this clip is obviously slow-mo skip clip. Yeah, and by the way, if you want to do slow-mo, you can do it the janky way. You could shoot it in regular motion and slow it down because there are... So here, like when I click this, right? Go down in the bottom here. Now here's where you can add text. You can add effects, which I don't typically do because effects, these are basically transitions, right? And then there's motion, auto reframe. This is some basic stuff that when you're gonna do effects, I would recommend Premiere Pro. But when it comes down to like cutting for timing's sake, so here you can go and click speed, and now range all. That's the two stopwatches. That's your range. That's the clip itself, and it says 100%. So I click on range speed. I'm gonna bring it to 25%, maybe dramatic effect. Let's see. Super janky. But hey, in some worlds, that's funny. In many worlds, it could be funny, especially when you're cutting for dramatic effect. You can also speed things up quite easily. It's just a little tougher to slow things down because when you don't shoot in a high frame rate, you're just taking 24 frames per second at that point and stretching them out. So it's a little artificial feeling, but it's something you can do. So we're gonna bring that back to normal speed. We're gonna head over to this clip. This is kind of like a punch in on the other shot. So you can see, I find the moment I like where it just kind of gets interesting. And then we're gonna click the spot before it and delete that. Now, it gets uninteresting pretty fast. So we're gonna give ourselves as little time as possible on that clip. Of course, Casper's gonna like that branding. And we're gonna bring this forward because as you can kind of see, it cuts with this. So it's kind of just another, it's, you know, you can cut away, keep it visually interesting. So here's how that looks. Yeah. So yep, turn the corner, another cut. Here I come. Now we've gotten this far. We've gotten 12 seconds in, and it's feeling pretty smooth. Katie, question, if you're uploading footage where someone is talking the whole time, does it split the audio and video at the same time, or do you have to do that separately? So that's a good question. Right now, it's cutting the audio and video together for me. But let's show an example where we can separate them, because sometimes someone's going to be talking, and you're going to like the voice, you're going to like their what they're saying, but you're not going to want to show them speaking the whole time because you want to keep it interesting. So a part of me thinks that this audio is very uninteresting. The audio is basically nothing. It's just white noise. So I can hear the footsteps in this clip. So we're gonna take this, click on it, separate audio. Now this audio is on its own. So you'll be cutting the audio separately from the video. So now click on the video, click on the audio. Now they're separated, which is one of the things that I think makes Premiere Rush great. Because you can do obviously more editing than TikTok. So now I'm going to drag this audio to the start. So this audio is going to be, I'm going to click this clip here. I'm going to click audio down at the bottom, mute clip. Cool. So this audio is now, throughout this part. So it sounds a little better. Yeah. So, and then, you know, it's those audio cuts are important. So sometimes it's kind of like kind of cut weird. So we're gonna let that run out a lot more intuitive than Unlink on Premiere Pro. Yeah, it's quick. It really is quick. So it really is the rushed program where you can, and so you could see it snaps to the point. So I love when it snaps too, because you can really make sure you're precise with your cuts. Oh, see, that went a little past. Boom, snap it. So I'm not liking how that last footstep sounds. So I might actually cut before that because it's kind of weird. Let's see. Yeah, that sounded better. We didn't like let it linger too long. This clip might even be lingering too long. So we're going to cut that down. As you guys know, the attention span is just ridiculously short. So if you find a clip that goes, what is this, 3 seconds? Yeah, see, that might need, we'll just trim that down like 2.5 seconds. Let's see that again. All right, so that's feeling pretty good. We're looking good on the edit now. We let this all play out, long clip. And then we got some more here. We cut when we see the clip start to happen. That's a funny clip, but it's a long clip. So maybe we split it here. We kill the end here. Maybe we come back. We like here, this funny stride. And maybe we like seeing me round the corner, but you know, it gets boring. So maybe we just cut out the middle, see how that does. Unlink hack for Premiere is you can deselect the double track in the toolbar by the magnet, and you can individually select them. That is true. So in Premiere Pro, you can do that. There is a quick tool, and we'd be happy to do a Premiere Pro cutting lesson as well. But there is like a quick tool on the timeline to unlink your clips. So what I did was just deleted that clip. So yeah, that feels pretty good. There we go. And we're not going to let much time go by here before we get into the next clip. It's always nice. Like, I haven't left frame yet, and I'm entering the next frame. Almost feels a little bit like a Mario. We'll call that the Mario effect. You know, leave frame one side, enter frame the next. And then it's just, you know, the second I'm about to leave, we just cut it. So it feels a little bit like a loop. So we're looking at like a 17 second piece. Maybe that's a little long. Let's see. This cut's a little weird. say. Maybe just two skips, you know? It's just the, let's see. Yeah, I think it's just like how many, you know, you don't let anything linger. Let's see. It's always nice to see if you can trim something down to 15 seconds. Just that golden 15. All right. It's almost like this clip almost lingers just a hair. And then this one. The cool thing here, too, is that Premiere Rush gives you a lot of nice transform tools. That's one thing I really like about it. So go into this transform section. We can go and you can crop the top. You know, maybe there's something up there that I don't need. Crop the top. Crop the bottom. But we're not going to crop. Instead, we're going to go to scale width. And since it says lock scale, all we need is the width. So we're going to scale up. Just because, like, you know, it's very important in those first few seconds on a TikTok that the viewer knows exactly what's happening. Unless it's, like, supposed to be intentionally confusing. But that's a rare scenario. So here we go. And I haven't even entered the frame yet, so I think that's going to dictate this cut a little bit. We're going to cut into that. There we go. Yeah, so I mean, now we've cut it down to 14 seconds, just under 15, so that really feels proper in just the snappiness. What else is cool is, you know, you really don't have to do much on your computer with this, because I just downloaded some sound effects from Epidemic Sound, as you guys have probably all used. And so I'm gonna try those out here. It's like squeaky sounds. Let's see if, like, shoe squeaks. I'm gonna see if, like, I can just put those in one at a time, airdrop them to my phone. They'll obviously go to the files. Let's see. So if you can add that to your files, you can actually pull up, boom, files, basketball, and you just save it to your, you know, it'll go to your recents. Let's try another one of those. Boom. Save to files. Cool. Let's do a third one because you need that variety. Can't be too repetitive. Third sound. Save to files. So it looks like we got the three Epidemic Sounds there. Cool, cool, cool. That's in our files, right? Goes to our recents. Now, we'll go back here, click the plus at the bottom left. Gotta make sure I'm not blocking anything, right? Nah, I feel like I'm in a good place. I hope so. Maybe I'll move myself up a little bit, just a little bit, over to the side. There. Cool. So hit the plus, we'll go to your media, we'll go to files here in local. Now, import from files, and there you can see the three. So we'll just click on that. Oh, we can actually select all three. One, two, three, add. Now, the sound effects are now in. It's just like on a computer. You got your sound effect files. We can drag them around. And you can see that I think we can get up to three layers of audio. So if I hit voice over here, you can see there's track one, track two, track three. Now, click the microphone to switch the track that you're recording on. So then if I wanted to, I could make some voiceover happen here. It could be like, you know, kind of strategic about what you're doing, but it gives you a 3, 2, 1. Lulululu. And then, yep, that's like maybe your voiceover clip that introduces what's going on, you know, catches people's attention. That's probably not going to work out for this video, but let's just see. And then, yep, super stupid. But just an example of how you can do voiceover here. And it's going to come through really clear. You can obviously connect different microphones to your phone. One thing that just like works out for like connecting microphones is that little dongle, right? The one that it's not near me, but you guys know what I'm talking about, the little adapter for your phone. Because you can connect professional level microphones to your setup. You guys know what I'm talking about. It's the little adapter for your iPhone. And then there's this. This is incredible. If you guys have, post it like this, please. Awesome. I'm so glad you guys like the edit. So I can add like the Lulu. Maybe I'll turn that down a little, because what you could do is you can come to audio here, right? Click audio, clip volume, right? It's at 50 right now. Let's bring it down to like 8, and let's just see what that does. Oh, I guess we can't really... Okay, so it's got to come up to like 25. Let's see. So that had potential. It sounds a little more distant. Maybe 17, it sounds super distant. We'll work on it. But it feels like it's in character. I want to make sure I mention this. The iRig Pre 2. This thing is a production wonder. I'll hold it closer to the camera. iRig Pre 2. Check this thing out. This thing. Look at that. This thing is super duper nice when it comes to... This thing is super nice because it has a XLR port. So when you have a condenser microphone or any type of microphone that has an XLR, you know, the big cables that they use in concerts, the Echo works. Yeah, it does somehow. And so if you have any like professional grade microphone with a condenser and an audio mixer, you can connect it here. You turn on phantom power on the side. You have a monitor, so you can plug in your headphones up top, and then this goes right into your phone. This piece can go right into your phone. The iRig Pre 2 is... And so this, I'll get voiceovers directly into TikTok through this. So you can do like green screen video, have like a mic of this nature, or like any microphone will sound great. Literally, you could spend like less than 100 on a microphone. Let's check out the iRig Pre 2. It is $60. And don't quote me, but do quote me. I think you could probably get it expensed, like based on whatever project you're doing. Because this thing is an absolute workhorse. Just 2 AA batteries, and you get the 48 volts of phantom power directly into your phone. Your audio improves greatly. You're doing voiceover. You're doing any kind of content. Because having that quality audio matters. Not just some Lulu type stuff. So, back to the edit. You can kind of see how we have our squeaks in here. I wonder if we'll be able to really time it out, or if this is a job for, you know, this is a job for Premiere Pro. Because sometimes, you know, you can... Sometimes there are jobs for Premiere Pro. That's the fact of the matter. If it's something more intense with sound design, Premiere Pro. Let's see. So another thing you can double click when you're like, oh, I'm too tight. Double click the project. You back all the way out. So you can kind of see everything. Then you can come back in. And you know, it's like, sometimes it's not a friend of big thumbs. Look at that. It's like the big thumbs will get you. So don't have big thumbs. Just kidding. All right, here we go. So another thing that I guess you guys totally get the gist on this project. So this, and then another, so I think we're ready to export, like you guys were saying. Oh, that's funny. See, that is actually working. Those are the three sound effects. Yeah, that seems to be working, honestly. So Epidemic Sound, you can literally drop in. I'm going to continue to finesse that later, but you get the gist, right? You find your sound effects, you can drop it in. If you plan this kind of thing out, you can literally make your edit on the train, road trip, anywhere. Plane, train, cars, automobiles. So another project I wanted to, what is this? Project status, some media can't be found. Missing media. Well, I don't see that happening anywhere, so I call BS. I see all the media. And I'm sorry, but I think we're gonna mute that voiceover until we find something that makes a little bit more sense. So next, a lot of us know that, you know, doing like skits is such a fun thing on TikTok, right? So doing a skit with yourself, right? Cause you don't need anyone else but yourself when it comes to TikTok. Oh, so I mean, I just kind of made the same project twice. So here is, let's do something with some voice where you're talking to yourself. You could be talking about the brand. You could be talking about literally anything. You're trying to send a message. So what is the message? Well, this one will be pretty simple. This is called What's Rush? Right? All right. So it's a little weird. You know, you have to like type in your project and then you'll get kind of frozen here. So you have to like click out of it, add a clip, and then don't add it. That's one thing I find to be a little weird about the program. So you'll create it. Show of hands, anyone think they're going to use Premiere Rush after this? Because it's fine if you're not. Maybe you like CapCut, maybe you like Premiere Pro, but it'd be interesting to see if people will dive in here, because there are some nice benefits to using it. And also the iRig Pre too. If you guys walk away with one of those in your arsenal, major level up. And it's cheap enough, I believe.
Hey.
All right, so this is dialogue. Let's see how fast we can edit this.
Hey. Guess what?
All right, so it's going to have to be, you know, chopped up. Let's chop. Let's go ahead. What I'll typically do is I'll go and make cuts at all the dialogue points so we can just kind of clean out the crap from this. But I'll do both sides of the conversation separately. And then these are effective a lot of times because they just feel so genuine. They just feel like it's just so tactile and human. And
you gotta know this kind of thing. You gotta know.
So we're making our cuts. We clean out all the dead space. There's some fun tools here when it comes to audio. Like if you have a lot of background noise, there is reduce noise, reduce echo. It seems like I'm having a little bit of echo, so you can do that, and it is effective. Type voice, that's cool. What else is this? Type voice. I'm not sure what did I just do.
You gotta know this kind of thing. You gotta know about.
Oh, you basically list what kind of type it is, and then I think you can literally like do some sound mixing. So there is like an on the fly sound mixing. Definitely sticking to my InShot. Probably going to use it for more complex audio video sync. Yeah, that's awesome. That is awesome. I mean, InShot is I know Katie uses InShot and it looks really great too. It's cool to kind of see what all these different programs use or what they can all do.
It's important.
Show of hands in the chat, because this is interesting to me. How long does it typically take you guys to make a piece? Because, you know, speed is the name of the game, but quality is also a factor. So I'm wondering kind of where the sweet spot for you is in just production time, start to finish.
Being software, I use it. All my friends use it.
There we go, make a cut. Here we go.
It's basically like Premiere, but when you're in a rush.
So, film or just edit? I think both, but I guess edit time, because edit times can be the big thing that slows people up, I feel. Shooting and editing can take up to around an hour. Well, that is fast. That is fast. I'll just say that. That is fast as fuck, boy. All right.
Hence the name.
And honestly, another reason to advocate for Premiere Rush and InShot and all those types of programs is because when you get feedback and you need to, like, you've already put your piece in TikTok, let's say you've shot it in TikTok, you've done all the steps, you have a change to make. It's not very easy in TikTok, but when you have this project in here, you're able to obviously make tweaks a lot more nimbly, and it's not going to drive you as crazy as obviously, like, maybe you have to go and redo your TikTok for all we know. Maybe you already posted it as a draft. This is a good way to avoid that, especially when you consider that reposting can be so effective on TikTok. We do believe that, well, it's been proven that reposting TikToks a week or two down the road when they are successful or we want to retest them, this allows you to do that because you have it saved here. All your projects, you know, all your projects stay active. So you can revisit them, repurpose. You can go back into your project library, duplicate it, rename it. You can delete it, obviously, save some room because things are going to get a little busy on your phone. So just consider that. And what I'll do, people will ask me about text in Premiere Rush. What I'll do is I will save the text. No text at that point because you can add, you know, the TikTok text in app. And then you can add like TikTok sounds. So you can still do things natively, but that's not going to take very long once you've already made your edit. And then you can obviously go to, Instagram Reels, YouTube Shorts. You save yourself that headache of like, I made a TikTok. We got the TikTok text. Everything's locked in place because everything's got the different text. You want to maintain that native feel. All right, so here we go.
I bet.
So bear with me. This is not going to be the best sketch you've ever seen.
Okay, cool.
But this is just an example of how I'll edit a video pretty fast. And keep in mind, what I'll do a lot of times is you're not going to be able to really do the green screen thing in this, so that's something to consider when you're doing green screen video. Probably want to do that in, well, there's a couple programs, I believe InShot and potentially CapCut can do that feature. But TikTok, of course, has the green screen. So if you're logged into the brand account, you know, you'll take your screenshots or your video. And I recommend using stills for your green screen because what that gives you is the option to adjust your clips after the fact. If you're doing green screen with video behind you, you can no longer adjust the length of your shots. It feels a little bit like a glitch on TikTok, but it's only when you're using JPEGs behind you. You can trim the edit tight, which is always recommended on TikTok. Keep it short, keep it concise, snappy. So just remember that. And another factor is to screenshot your whole screen in your camera roll when you, so for example, right? So you got like a cropped image. Like let's just say this was small. Let's say this was a square image. Right? Let's say this was square. And I wanted like a full screen green screen on TikTok. We had a lot of fun in the mall yesterday. If I was to green screen this as it currently is, my body would be constrained to the square frame. But if I screenshot it, now it's full frame. So I would be filling the frame from the top to the bottom, and I just have more room to play in. So it's something to consider when you're doing green screen on TikTok. That's a whole separate concept than Premiere Rush, but for green screen video, which I highly recommend, that's kind of the technique I like to follow. So now back to Premiere Rush. We got a little dialogue going. So, kind of show you how you can kind of create some overlapping dialogue, because there's a lot of people here that are pretty solid with scripts and concepts of that nature. I'm going to continue to cut out.
Premiere, hush. I am trying to focus. More like Premiere, hush.
I'm going to continue to cut out all of our talking points. Boom, boom, boom. And remember, you can also like reorder clips, so that's cool. I can bring them on top of each other. This is just something to check out. Let's say you wanted to create your own duet. You wanted to make it look new, native. So, transform. Go to scale. We'll go to enter 50. We'll go here. We'll do the same thing. 50. Now they are both floating on top of each other. Horizontal position. Now this one. Horizontal position. Look at that. Artificial duet. So you could download your original clip. Excuse me. Sorry guys, I've had this cough. So that's like a really fun way to create a duet. This is fun. So you can undo everything. Boom. One, that's at the top. You can see the undo arrow. One, two, three. But, oh wait, I actually wanted that. So you hold it down, you can click redo. So this is all starting to feel like a computer, right? Because it kind of behaves that way. So that's pretty fun. I wonder how much better the mobile editing could get. I'd be very interested to see if you guys have hacks for green screen, because that is the one thing that I really feel is missing on Premiere Rush is the green screen effect. So if there's a way off the app, I mean, CapCut seems like a logical place to go for that, because I think CapCut is by TikTok itself. So that'd be interesting. Give me a shout if you guys have any hacks on that. So we're cutting. Let's see, boom, trimming. There's a couple different ways you can like really trim and edit. So you can do like the drag, I like to do split, it just feels quicker. Split, delete, split, boom, boom. I guess I made this dialogue kind of long. Let's see. But you can see that you can really keep it moving pretty quickly. This is just my style of editing. I mean, everyone can do different things. And what's cool is that let's say you like wanted to act like, you know, you had someone who didn't want to be on camera and also didn't want to act behind camera, but you wanted them to say something, but they didn't want to say something. So you sit there at your desk and they approach you with the camera, right? and you're like noticing them, what you can do is they don't have to say anything. You could do the dialogue from your desk and be like, "What? I'm working on it. Blah blah blah." And you can do a voiceover of yourself speaking to yourself, like you're behind the camera and you're in front of the camera. Like that could be a fun style as well, to keep you from being limited by, you know, who wants to be on camera, who wants to act. I love the CapCut feature where you can grab sounds from TikTok. Love that. I'd love to hear more about that. Grabbing sounds from TikTok. That's awesome. Including use made ones. Yeah, I think that's really cool. CapCut is probably pretty great because it has those TikTok features included. And I need to try that one out indeed. So here we go. We're splicing away. It looks like the dialogue is just about over. So I'll create all my cuts before I move things around. Typically helps move things along faster. You can see, again, you click on the clip to make your splits move along in the edit. There you go. So now we back out, we double click, and we can kind of see the whole project there, and we can start to order things. So click this and bring it up to the front. So I say, hey, and you get to see here that when you can start to layer things in, it can be pretty dynamic even on a very simple scene.
Hey, guess what? More like Premiere Hush.
Oh, did I? I feel like I missed a line, so I could do voiceover here. So you can always make up for anything like that and go, what? So you can add your voiceover. There's always a way to make up for those little things. And then drag that over.
What? Premiere Rush. More like Premiere Hush. I am trying to focus. Premiere Rush? You gotta know this.
So I don't know why, but this timeline isn't moving the way it typically does. So typically it'll, maybe if I drag it up. Gotta sometimes back out. But you can see that these dialogue scenes can be done in Premiere Rush. I feel like I won't belabor the point. I think it'd be nice to get some questions from you guys, just with the time we have left. We have 12 minutes. Love to hear some of you guys' questions about creating, you know, equipment to use, stuff like that, and different methods in Premiere Rush and outside of Premiere Rush, because there's really so many options. So any questions that come to mind, fire away. Let's see.
Premiere Rush. What about it?
I guess it's kind of cool to like cut put like a clip here and like have the voiceover inner, like, so you can do the separate audio. Do you ever notice a lag in video audio after edit with Rush? I haven't noticed that. Have you noticed that? So what I like to do is, I haven't had that lag. Sometimes I'll notice that there's a visual glitch. Sometimes like a data moshing glitch. I've had that be an issue before with InShot native TikTok editing. Oh, it's interesting. Yeah, I think that's kind of like a bitrate issue sometimes, when, because I feel like the rendering machine for Rush is actually pretty good. So if you take a look here at our project that we made, you still got all the audio. It seems definitely gonna want to add more of the shoe squeaks from Epidemic. But when you click up at the top right, you get the export, so it'll give you like quality settings, and you can go preset automatic, you can go 4K match frame rate, and you can obviously change the frame rate. I would never recommend changing the frame rate. I would match it, but you can see it's 4K quality high, estimated file size, so it really acts as a computer would, and you can see how it renders. Don't close Rush. You want to keep it up as you render. I have with Rush in the past may just have been because it's an older version. That's interesting. So Kevin, you had an issue with Premiere Pro. Sounds like CapCut is a great program to try out when it comes to TikTok creating. I wonder if it works as well for all platforms like IG Reels, but I'm very open to trying out Instagram or CapCut as well. So let's see. So we check it out. Goes to the camera roll. 15 seconds, kind of the sweet spot. That'll loop pretty nicely. The audio is lagging when uploading to TikTok. Yeah, let's chat on that on the side if I, because I'm not sure. It could be with Premiere's export options. That there could be something to check out there when it comes to the audio bitrate. Because sometimes when your bitrate isn't high enough, you'll have an audio lag. So that's something to definitely look into when it comes to the audio bitrate. And what like are you editing? Like, are you exporting ProRes? Something I'd love to take a look at. So this program, so if you can, like, if you shorten the clip, so you see, like, you can do some audio overlap, which I always find to be really fun. And sometimes I'll just separate all the audio so that you can kind of just create a little more dynamic scene.
I am trying to focus. Premiere Rush. What about it?
So yeah, it's always fun. Like, it makes your scene just feel more dynamic than just your average TikTok, because you're not really going to be able to do this on TikTok.
I am trying to focus. Premiere Rush. What about it?
So you can shorten that. Separate the audio again. What about it?
What about it? Premiere Rush. You got to know this kind.
So let's see. I'll be sure to try that next time I have the issue. Yeah. Yeah. It could be a storage thing, because sometimes when you're rendering with low storage, your RAM just doesn't act the same. Your computer's memory. So something to take a look there. And again, this, I just love all these features down at the bottom. When it comes to audio, Premiere Rush is pretty clutch. Just having this this audio where you can go quiet and you can mute something.
It's basically like Premiere, but...
And it gets really loud. Let's take a look at that.
It's basically like Premiere, but when you're in a rush.
So, and then just these different ways you can scale things. So let's take a look at that. You want to go picture in picture? You can do that. Where is that? Scale width and like we'll crop the top and the bottom. You'd be broadcasting about yourself here. Let's see. Boom. You do picture in picture for like a news report or, you know, like a vlog of some kind. That would be a way to do like an alternative green screen. You could do something like that. You know, you can lay in, I think, at least three. Yeah, it's three images on top of each other. So that could be really fun. Like, create your own template. That's always a fun way to do it. And that's obviously a way you can do duets, where you kind of line people up next to each other. Let's see. Speed is really fun. You know, those sped up TikToks always just seem to do really well. So if you're speed anything up by like 100, like just like 125%, there's just something supernatural about it, especially like someone walking or just someone doing something. I just find 125% to be a really fun way to kind of cheat it. What else, guys? Any other questions? It's been a great session, and I'm here to help with any questions you guys have had regarding Rush. Just to recap, this is how a project looks. You can zoom in. You click on different clips, it'll navigate you through the project. Making splits is really easy in the clip. This is gonna be the ideal program for your more basic editing. Again, there's so many options. There's Premiere Pro, which it appears a lot of you guys do. There is CapCut. We've talked about CapCut. It appears that works really nicely with TikTok. So don't be shy about any of these programs. They all act pretty similarly. Remember, this is your project window. Let's see. I did this one for a response for Casper. I'm responding to a comment. And then I screen recorded the audio off TikTok so I could go.
It's my girlfriend to let me listen to my sleep playlist.
Pickles, pickles, pickles. Just a little pickle on the side of my sandwich.
So that was Peter Pappalardo on Bose, this pickle, pickle, pickle song he made, which was just hilarious. And you can quickly pull something down from TikTok, add it to your files again. So as a recap, you go into your bottom here, your locations, click files, import from files, boom. You got this will just do the basketball sounds again. So you can import multiple things at a time. And so like that was my sleep playlist in that video. But again, these are Epidemic sounds. Airdrop them to your phone, have them in your files.
Just a little pickle.
Definitely doesn't work in this scenario, but again, it's just so easy to add these sound effects. And we're going to have a recording of this session uploaded, and you guys will be able to look back at this stream and just hopefully be able to thrive on Premiere Rush. I think you will, because I think you're going to find just the speed to be really helpful. And you're not going to have to sacrifice quality for speed. So yeah, Simon, I'm glad you liked it. I'm working on my stream game myself. So this was a fun, yeah, I'd love to do more of these, and we can do like any topic. So you guys, feel free to reach out. I've worked in Premiere Pro. I haven't worked in the other edit softwares, but I'd be down to also just do like a TikTok tutorial, where we nerding out over here. Yeah, I love it. And remember, because I, I, I'm not sure if it recorded this whole thing, to be quite honest, but remember the iRig Pre 2. Very, very, very awesome device. Remember, it's got the XLR input. It's got phantom power on the side. That's key, because you have to power these microphones. These microphones need a lot of power. If you have your interface, you may or may not need an interface. I have a very small one that's USB. So if you have a USB interface, they can run pretty cheap. And then a monitor for your headphones. So you can take a look. And then this cord runs right into your phone. So you can make TikToks, do your voiceovers, do your voice memos. Clean, crisp audio. Makes a huge difference. And that's one tool I would just recommend. Another tool is like literally a desktop tripod, like these Manfrotto legs. That's what I was using for this whole session. I have like a little bit of an arm setup going on, and then a Manfrotto phone holder. I swear by Manfrotto. I'm a Stan Frodo. I'm a Manfrotto Stan. So equipment too. Really, really key, because this is like desktop. Then I have a green screen. These are all desktop items. So they're designed to be pretty affordable. So something to keep in mind when you guys are making TikToks. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you for listening. I hope you learned something. And until next time, because there will be a next time. Give me a shout on Slack with anything else that you want to cover. And just let's collab. Great to meet you all. And have a terrific day. Now, how do I end the stream? Peace out, guys. Thank you so much for coming. And now we end the stream.